Hello, this is Dr. Niles Crane, filling in for my ailing brother, Dr. Frasier Crane. Although I feel fully qualified to fill Frasier's radio shoes, I should warn you that while Frasier is a Freudian, I am a Jungian. So there'll be no blaming mother today. Okay, Roz, who's my first caller?
We have Marsha on line three. She's in love with her husband's brother.
This day promises not to disappoint. Hello, Marsha. Let's get better. Howard, Lois, I could stay on the air counseling you all afternoon, but we're coming to the end of our hour, so I'm just going to cut to the quick. If one of you doesn't say I love you right now, frankly, I don't see how you could have any kind of future together. So, which of you has the courage to say I love you?
Howard, I love you.
Yes!
Yes! Howard, she loves you! What about you? Howard? You gonna just pack up your emotional tent and walk away? Howard? Howard, it's up to you. Can you say it? Can you?
Come on, Howard. Come on, Howard.
I love you too, Lois.
Yeah!
Hello, Niles. I've come to take back the reins of my show so you can just scoot out of there.
I think this might be a good time to go to a commercial. This is Dr. Niles Crane. Let's get better.
You okay, Frasier? Your eyes look a little glassy.
I'm fine. It's just that the drugs I took have some minor side effects.
Frasier, look at me. Do you see trails when I do this?
Whoa! I wasn't doing that before.
All right, now, you're not going on the air like this. Now, stop it. Step. This is what you're going to do. You're going to go to bed, you're going to get rest, you're going to get rid of this fever, so you can be as good as new. Let's get better. All right?
All right. Okay. Maybe the two of you could help me find someone to drive me home.
Oh, that's okay. The most sensible thing you've said so far, Frasier. Frasier!
Hello, Seattle. I'm back. This is Dr. Frasier Crane, and I promise I will never leave you again. So, let's take our first caller.
Hello? I'm listening.
Hi, Dr. Crane. Thanks for taking my call. I'm a little nervous, okay? My name is Robert.
And your name is?
My name is Robert.
Oh, I'm sorry. We've already had a Robert on the show today. Goodbye.
Tony, it's Roz. Could you get security up here? Captain Kirk's got control of the bridge and he's gone insane.
Who is this?
I'm Janice.
Well, Janice, what's your problem?
Well, I'm having a problem breaking through a barrier with my in-laws.
Boring!
Hello, you're on the Crane with Frasier Air.
Hi, Dr. Crane, this is Marjorie. You see, I'm having a problem with my boss. He doesn't seem to respect me, and I don't have the courage to confront him.
Okay, Marjorie. Well, let's see. Let's do a little role-playing, okay? Now, look, I'll be your boss. You be yourself. You be Marjorie. And come on in and talk to me in a very forceful way and tell me what you think, and you just might be surprised at what happens.
Well, okay. Listen, Mr. Ross, I've worked for this company for 6 years, and I've never missed a day. But you've constantly promoted people less qualified than I am, and I don't think that's fair.
Oh, well, Marjorie, I must say I admire your forthrightness, and I wish more of my employees came and spoke to me with an open mind, and you know you're going to get that promotion.
Hey, that was great.
Yeah, wasn't it? Okay, it's my turn. I'm Marjorie, you're the boss now, okay? Come on!
Frasier, these nice men are going to take you home.
I'm doing my show. I can't. I'm on the air.
No, you're not. We cut you off. You're on commercial.
Don't you worry your little mucus-filled head about anything we have. Everything's under control.
It's my show. It's my booth. Hey, this is fun. Make it go faster.
5 seconds, Niles.
Hello, this is Dr. Niles Crane again, and no, we haven't taken leave of our senses. That bit of inspired lunacy you heard before the commercial was just a little docudrama Frasier and I put together on the dangers of over-medication.